in the house. My pleasure to be here. We got a lot of the rock stars in the building. We got Carmine Appice from the Vanilla Fudge up there. Say hello. Come on. And the Hoosier Mama's here somewhere. Pepe's been lonely. This is, I usually announce Pepe's different shows. I've done a Barnaby Bye, I've done a Wiggy Bits, and I thought that was enough of the crazy names until he asked me to do the Blues Magoos. So the Blues Magoos are here finally. Are we here, Pepe? Let's hear it from Pepe. Let's hear it from Ralph. And our boy Jeff Dakin. I want to thank everybody for coming. Not that it's my fault you're here. Thanks again for supporting the Rascals. I appreciate it. I certainly didn't get this kind of audience last year. This is a great place for my first time here. If I can find my fiance, I'll be okay. Debbie, where are you? Pepe didn't come equipped. Anyway, here they are, ladies and gentlemen. The Blues Magoos! So after a 47-year snooze,
time to wake up.
All aboard! Now leaving on track 69 from 1967 in the Night Owl Cafe. Arriving 2014 in 30 seconds. At the Rockin' Sockin' Bowery Electric in New York City.
Yeah.
If somebody told me 50 years ago in the Night Owl Cafe, 50 years later, you were going to be sitting in a cellar with all your friends and loved ones.
You're too effing loud.
This is outrageous. So I want to thank Diane Gentile. She's the house chick here. She kicks ass. She plays her ass off. She's a great writer, singer. She's been building this room up in New York for the longest time. DJ La 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 Linda. And of course, my favorite, The Sins. How are The Sins, right? They get my vote. I drank the Kool-Aid. So I got to tell you something. Before I move on, this gentleman way in the back, by the name of Joe Mara. Night Owl Cafe, Joe Mara. Okay, Joe Mara was the owner of the Night Owl Cafe. And when Joe, he rotated five bands a night, five bands during the week. We all played four sets a night, six nights a week. It was fabulous. I was 15 years old and I had a different girlfriend every other night. It was like, whoa! So, we start playing psychedelic music because our echoplex fell off the piano. And when we picked it back up, it was going woo, woo, woo. We were like, oh shit. And then we moved the tape and went woo, 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 woo. We were like, wow, that's cool. So then we incorporated it into the music. But Joe Mara hated it. He hated it. And he was like, you fucking guys is too fucking loud. If you play that shit, you're out of my club. So one night we say, oh, fuck Joe, we're just gonna do this no matter what. We're just gonna have fun and screw Joe, right? We're thinking he loves us no matter what, right? So this is a line I remembered for the next 50 years. It's still one of my all-time favorite lines. So we're on stage and we're doing like this little psycho bit. And all of a sudden, we see the lights start going, like this. And we're going, holy shit, Joe's into it. And Joe's telling us to get the hell off the stage. We're fired, right? So now we get off the stage and he goes, come here, come here. He brings us back to the kitchen. He goes, I told you fucking guys, you guys, it's too fucking loud. You're out of here. And we go, Joe, how can you do this? How can you fuck us like this? And he goes, hey, if you can't fuck your friends, who can you fuck? Come on.
Joe Mara.
Is that classic New York? Joe Mara, we love you. He's back there. This was off Basic Blues Magoos, which is really one of my favorite all-time Magoozy records. We'll try and get through this. It's called There She Goes. Well, anybody can drink some water up here. I'd love some water. Well, you guys can start it already. What? A one, a two, a three, a out.
We'll be right back.
three-day rehearsal version.
Was that a fire alarm?
Did I bring a string?
No, I am not mooning the audience. But there's a dear, 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 wonderful friend of mine I know forever. And every once in a while, occasions like this come up. And then your friends come out and you really know who your friends are and they really come to support you. And so all my buddies, I see you, I actually see my crew. But this, if you're all good, because the sin drained the hell out of me, I needed a blood transfusion after watching The Sins. But this is made by Carrie Ash. I call it Ashmosphere. And it's pure chocolate. So I think maybe another song I should start passing around, we should eat this friggin' thing. Now in the old days, our records, because it was vinyl, we used to say if you didn't like it because it was black, we used to say it was licorice, so if you didn't like our record, you could eat it. But that's that one. Carrie, I love you. Thank you, sweetie. Jeff starts this one. I love it when drummers count themselves off. Say hello to Ralph Scala, the original voice of We Ain't Got Nothing Yet. And although Mike Esposito, who is Espo, who is our lovable old father Mike, he's getting up there in years. He wasn't up for the testosterone boost. So we went from Mike Esposito to Mike Siliberto. And then a really one old thing is this guy, Peter Stewart Coleman. He is so fabulous. When he first started rehearsing with us, he knew our songs better than we did. And he'd go, guys, excuse me, but that's not exactly what you played on the record. We're like, well, show us. So he showed us our own stuff.
Yeah.
Now, mind you, behind me is Mr. Jeff Dakey. Jeff, outside of being a Magoozy, he is an audio legend. He is a gyro gear loose of the first order. This guy invents things, makes things. He has his own line of gear called Dakey, which the biggest producers in the world use. He makes boards, compressor, mic frees. I know it's boring to you guys, but he's got, there are so many icons in this audience tonight. You should give yourself an all. I have fashion icons here. I have audio icons here. I have rocker icons here. I have general people. I love icons. I hear you guys are fabulous. So it's just good. The Magoos is a great license to be silly. So when we actually decided we were going to actually put out a record called Psychedelic Erection, Psychedelic Resurrection, you know, there used to be, when we used to go out and eat back in the day, we used to go to a Chinese restaurant, we always used to see Magoo Gai Pan. We always used to laugh, look there, they named the dish after us, Magoo Gai Pan, right? So we wrote this silly song called Crapo Distinko, Me Tummy's on the Blinko. It's about going to a Chinese restaurant and getting sick on Magoo Gai Pan. And here it comes.
Thank you to the Chinese restaurant next door.
Let's hear it for Pepe.
You know, I'm gonna change my name to Pappy next week, I think, after this one. I can't believe, really, I used to sing this. Like, a long time ago.
We did this one in the night out.
That 12-mile road that I used to roam. Sometimes I think about that girl named Willie Jean, wondering if she made it down. The folks back there wondering if they still have that old county fair. But sometimes I think about that girl named Willie Jean, wondering if she made it down. Yeah. Blues Magoos 1967! Well, now I don't need Viagra, that's for sure. Go, Ralphie! This is an ode to someone recently who passed away. You'll know who he is the minute you hear the song. If Ralph can get off his acid trip and find out where Juan is. Come on, Ralph! Come, baby! Thank you. Oh. Oh, look at you guys. How cool is this? You guys are so great. It's so great, you know, I get to do this after all that time. It really, really is amazing. So the ones that are here, I consider you all very special. My hats to you guys. My babes. Mwah. So, this song was the B-side of We Ain't Got Nothing Yet. It was written by a dear friend of ours named Alan Gordon. Alan Gordon passed away a few years ago. He asked me to do a project with him, which I was so happy to do before. But Alan wrote Happy Together by the Turtles. Alan wrote Celebrate by Three Dog Night. He Streisand and on and on and on. He was the most fabulous drummer. He was in a band back then, one of the rotating bands called The Magicians. And I think people like the song as much as We Ain't Got Nothing Yet. They love the song. It's called Gotta Get Away. Sing along. on the mic. Yeah, she comes around. She's a 5'9" from her head to the ground. No, she comes around here just about in line. Makes me feel so good, Lord. It makes me feel alright. And her name is Crazy SRF scholar. We got a lot of history. You know, first person to ever get me high was Graham Parsons. Okay. Ralph you know, when we were coming up, the President's Council on Physical Fitness was like a big thing. So Ralph, I don't know what he dropped that day, but he's like, hey man, I got a really cool idea. Let's write a song called President's Council on Psychedelic Fitness. And we did. And I love it. If you can imagine lyrics, we're not here to blow your minds. We're here just to help our kind. But the campaign has begun. Cheap teeth. The campaign has begun to get your head, to get your head, to get your head in shape, my friends, with the President's Council on Psychedelic Fitness. Changed our lives back forever, and we wrote the song in the basement of the Albert Hotel, which is now like a nice luxury condo on 10th and University Place. But these guys were actually crazy enough to let us rehearse in the basement of the hotel. And so one day we saw a water bug and it freaked us out, so we got a can of Raid and we sprayed it, and in 5 minutes there was like 5,000 water bugs all over the place. We're like, ah! And I said, we never rehearsed there again. But we did get this iconic song out of it, and it did change our lives. I mean, I used to go to bed sleeping on my mom's breast watching Jack Benny, and then all of a sudden I was standing next to him So it was rather trippy. Okay, ready for We Ain't Got Nothing Yet? What a night in New York. No place like home. One more? That's quick, because after three rehearsals in 50 years, this is all we rehearsed. But this thing took us around the world. We had the balls to release a record that was 7 minutes long in 1967. Naturally, all the radio stations went, "Are you nuts? We can't play this. But it's really friggin' cool." So they were like, "So if you give us a 3 minute song, we'll definitely play it." So this did pave the way for We Ain't Got Nothing Yet for us. And it was one of our signatures. Get ready, we've been known to spit and fart in this one and everything else. So. It's called The Back Around!
Back. Only you know the how. back a row.
Jeff Dankin, Peter Stewart Coleman, Mike Silverberto, and what's left of Pepe Castro.
Chocolate!